Hi guys, this is Sushant Gochar. Today we are going to talk about why there are so many myths in fitness industry. So you must have come across a lot of myths in fitness industry that you need to be taking. You essentially need to be taking protein powder to build muscle, or you essentially need to eat eggs to be healthy. So things like that. So the one of the most important reasons why there are so many myths in fitness industry is that most of the people don't know anything, or most of the people don't know most of the things. So they would accept as they are told. So if I tell someone that eat this much protein powder and you'll have a decently nice looking body, or you'll gain a lot of muscle, then I'll believe that person. That information on as I know it. I'll tell people that, oh, eat protein powder so you'll build muscle. People need health. People care about health. So they would try to adapt those things in their lifestyle, and they'll ask their mom, dad, family members, brothers, sisters, friends to adapt those changes as well. I'll tell my brother to take protein powder because if it's healthy, it will have him gain more muscle. So, because people need health and they care about their loved ones, so the myths in the fitness industry go viral very soon. So they create a chain of passing the wrong information. For example, a lot of people eat eggs because they think that eggs have a lot of protein and protein is good for health, so we should eat eggs. A lot of vegetarians start eating eggs because they think that eggs are healthy, but there are a lot of proven scientific harmful effects of eggs, and you can get protein from almonds as well, but you do not eat almonds just for protein. There are many other beneficial effects of almonds rather than just a small amount of protein. And that is also the case with eggs. There are a lot of harmful effects of eggs, and you get just a small amount of protein in return, which you can get from any other food source without the harmful effects. So basically, people do not know anything, so they pass on the information as it is, as they get it. Now, you cannot see what's happening inside your body, so it is hard to tell what's right and what's wrong. So if a gym trainer tells me that, oh, I gained all this muscle and this decently looking body and this huge size by just eating protein powder, so I would believe him and I'll start eating protein powder without giving a thought. That person might have gained muscle because he was following a good diet. Maybe he was on steroids. Maybe he was. Maybe he could have built the same body without protein powder, just being on the on a good diet, good healthy nutritious diet. So we do not know, because we cannot go inside the body and see how everything that we are eating is working inside our body, so it is hard to know. Then the third reason is that the science still doesn't know a lot of things precisely. If the science doesn't have information about a lot of things, someone can get away by saying whatever, and you cannot say that that person is wrong because there is no scientific proof. For example, in the United States around 1950 to 1960, the protein requirement recommended protein requirement was around 110 grams per day, which is about 50 grams per day for average human being now. So basically, what we know now proves what we knew in 1950 or 60 wrong. It proves that thing wrong. So what we know today can be proven wrong by what we know 100 years later when we are perhaps dead. So science doesn't know a lot of things precisely, so it is hard to tell if something is working right or wrong. For example, a lot of the protein requirement per day for a male or a female has been calculated based on a study on rats, so you do not know exactly how it turns out to be in humans on a solid basis. On a study based on a lot of people, and then there is false knowledge spread out by trainers. Many times, for monetary purposes, they would tell you that, oh, eat this protein powder, it will give you a decently nice looking body, because they get a commission or a benefit by selling it. A lot of times you might come across people who have taken steroids and they have huge size, a lot of muscle mass, and they'll tell you, I just took this piece of powder, and you just take that powder and you'll have the body, and then you you get the wrong knowledge, and then you keep spreading across people, oh, eat this powder and you'll have huge size just like him. Those kind of things. And then there are wrong images created by brands. So you'll see an advertisement flashing on television where there is a guy with a decent body, nice looking cuts, with a box of protein powder with him, and you'll create an image that, oh, eat this protein powder to have a body like him. Advertisements from many brands create these sort of images. For example, if you see a person running in a movie and exercising, and 15 minutes later they'll show him with a really nice looking body, you'll think that, oh, running gives you that kind of a body. So people form images. So those images can negatively impact and create myths. So I'll be breaking such few myths in my next few videos. If you like this video, like it, and if you like this video, especially this one and my upcoming few videos, please share them with your friends so that they know why there are so many myths and they know what the myths are in my future videos. And if you like the channel, please subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.